Cities all over the world are bursting with people. More than half of us live in cities now, and by 2050, that number jumps to nearly 70%. That's a lot of people. So how do we grow cities sustainably? And with the climate crisis, figuring out how we do that is more important than ever before. But there's one city that may be doing it better than any other place on Earth.
We want to become the first carbon neutral capital city by 2025.
So we packed up our gear and headed here to Copenhagen, Denmark to find out how. It's not surprising to learn that two-thirds of the world's carbon emissions come from cities. That number is getting worse as more of us move into cities, which means a higher demand on infrastructure and resources. So Copenhagen is on a mission to cancel out all of their carbon emissions.
My name is Frank Jensen, I'm the Lord Mayor of Copenhagen. When I became mayor, we started this process. We decided that we would want to become the first carbon neutral capital city by 2025.
What does carbon neutrality actually mean? For a city, it's creating more renewable energy than the dirty energy it uses. It's all about achieving a net zero. And their plan is focusing on mobility, pollution, and energy.
We have introduced a lot of new solutions in Copenhagen. Our bicycle infrastructure is world famous because today 62% of the Copenhageners use the bike for daily transportation.
Everyone in Copenhagen bikes, and I mean everyone. So the city is leaning into that. In the last 10 years, it has invested nearly $300 million to improve biking infrastructure. All that money has paid off. There are more than five times the amount of bikes than cars in the city. That goes a long way when cutting down on carbon emissions. But the effort doesn't stop there. Copenhagen has totally transformed their waterways too. Only a few decades ago, the harbor was contaminated with industrial waste, oil spills, even dead fish.
When I moved to Copenhagen back in 1987, this harbor was so polluted, you could never dream to have a swim in this harbor. But today you can swim, we have a harbor bath where people can have a swim with their kids after school or after job.
Though Copenhagen has made huge strides with their mobility and pollution efforts, by far their biggest focus is on energy use. It makes up about 80% of their carbon neutral plan. To cut down on their consumption, Copenhagen uses one of the world's largest and most successful district heating systems. It works by using a network of pipes to capture leftover heat from electricity production, then delivers that heat to homes across the city.
99% of all households in Copenhagen are linked to our very efficient district heating system. We have also introduced district cooling, where we take the cold out of the water in the harbor and distribute cold in pipes beside the district heating pipes. So you can reduce temperature in buildings, in server rooms, in factories. We can reduce electricity use for cooling down buildings with 70%.
To come up with these kinds of sustainable solutions, Copenhagen collaborates with partners across the city, like Copenhagen Solutions Lab, an incubator for smart city initiatives.
What Copenhagen Solutions Lab does is actually solving some of the bigger problems in the world by using technologies in order to accelerate this transition into a carbon-free economy. So for instance, the problem of air quality. People in cities are dying too early because of bad air, and that is a global problem, not just here in Copenhagen. Getting rid of our waste, measuring air quality, managing traffic, we're trying to solve these problems down in Street Lab.
Contrary to how it sounds, the Street Lab really isn't a laboratory. It's a 2 kilometer long chunk of downtown Copenhagen that serves as a testing area.
Placing a lab such as this downtown in a real urban environment makes it very realistic. Everything we're testing here will be able to survive in other parts of the city and will be able to be scaled to a citywide level. This is a new generation of technology that makes it possible to measure air quality by a sensor. And now we're looking into mounting sensors actually on a Google Street View car to make it possible to measure each and every street of Copenhagen.
With these sensors, the city can better locate the source of pollutants to help improve overall air quality. The technology has already proved so useful that Marius and his team are shipping sensors to countries like Norway, Mexico, Austria, Greece, and the US. Though Copenhagen is leading the way in sustainable smart city solutions, experts and policymakers will tell you that the true secret to the city's transformation is the people. The residents here actually want to help build a sustainable city and are willing to work for it.
The citizens of Copenhagen, they demand a high quality of urban life. They are willing to do a lot themselves. They want to sort their own garbage. They want to bike to work. Citizens' involvement is key to the way we think in Denmark and in the Nordic countries. And that's a huge driving force behind being a carbon neutral city by 2025.
Since I became mayor in 2010, we have a growth rate in the number of citizens with 20%. And even that, we have cut our emissions with 42% in the same period. So we show that you can have growth, green transformation, if you do the right investments in the city.
Copenhagen's transformation hasn't been easy. And of course, their size and wealth helps, but they've made it work for their city. Regardless if they hit their carbon neutral deadline, their ultimate goal is to serve as an example for cities everywhere.
The green transformation of cities and livability, and also, very important, good economy goes hand in hand. I see Copenhagen as a front runner to show for my colleagues and decision makers, you must go green.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed our series about the future of cities, check out our website for even more content. And don't forget to subscribe to Freethink.